what I was called for.
So before we talk about your whole discernment process of how you became a full-timer and how you started serving in Divine, so what really tipped you off to make that decision, Maria? Like, when did you decide, okay, I'm going to be a full-timer in Divine? Was there a day that you decided like that?
No, I never thought of coming to Divine. See, I've come here several times for retreat, for the youth retreats. And I didn't see myself fitting into this place. For one thing was I was English speaking and young and I was a girl and I didn't find anyone like that at that time here. I wanted to live for God and I had this time of personal prayer, but interestingly, I think it was during the course of my personal prayer, I knew I wanted to live for Jesus. How, I did not want to know. I did not know. And at one moment, I'm preparing for my civil services meanwhile because my parents want me to, not because I wanted to. And my mother meets a person who was supposedly gifted in prophecy. And so she took me there. And that was a negative experience which turned out, I think, for the best, because this lady said many things, and one of the things, you know, when my mother asked her about me doing civil services, the lady said, oh, she will never get it. And I was so happy. The next thing I asked her is, can I serve the Lord? And she said, what will God do with you? You're a woman, so you're a girl, you think, you start praying for the man you're to marry. And I was a bit upset about it, but I was not affected much, but my mother was affected. So she thought, I'm now wasting my time going for prayer meeting and all that. And meanwhile, I started telling the Lord, you don't need me, but I really want to live for you. And I was a little hurt about it, especially because my mother was taking it seriously. And at one point of time, I was so pressurized. I told the Lord, if you don't want me to live full time for you, see, by then I haven't a clear idea, but I knew I wanted to live for him. I said, fine, but what if I need you, so I will continue to pray. But if you want me to live for you, I need a sign. I was feeling guilty about testing God and asking God for a sign, but it kind of came to a point where my parents weren't very happy about me going for this prayer meeting, that intercession, this Bible class. So I actually asked God for a sign, and I asked him to give me a cross because I had lost the crucifix I had. So I asked God to give me a sign, and I said, God, if you want me to live for you, give me a cross. And I gave him a deadline. I said, in 1 week's time. The first 2 days, I actually went and met people who I thought would give me some kind of gift. You know, people like old people, pious people who gave me a cross. Nothing came, and by the third day, I kind of gave up. I was sitting in my room, my house, and I was looking at the Sacred Heart picture. I was telling Jesus, fine, if you don't want me to serve you, fine. And that's when my mom comes to me. My mom is like, who's like totally against my going for prayer meeting and porta and all this. She comes to me with a brown cover and says, I want you to get this blessed. And she said, I only want two or three remaining you can keep. Now, she didn't tell me what it was. I emptied the brown cover in my hand. It was a whole, maybe about 15 crosses, you know. And even at that moment, you know, hard and dumb as I was, I thought it's a coincidence. That which should come from my mother, if it came from some saintly priest or nun, you know, I would have said, wow. So, but I believe that was one moment. Another moment was when I was going to sleep. I remember one night, I clearly got this verse, Matthew 19:29. I was very tired that day and I didn't want to open the Bible. But because I was not getting sleep, this word was going on coming to my mind, and I put on the torchlight. My Bible was next to me. I opened and I saw this verse, you know, where Jesus says, whoever leaves father and mother and brother and land and house will receive 100 more. And I always thought it was a boring verse because I thought it was for priests and nuns. I read it, I felt very happy, but I still didn't think it was for me. So this was how I slowly was being drawn to the fact that I want to live for God. And Divine Retreat Center, I was always involved with their youth ministry. After a while, they started inviting me to come and serve here. I didn't know if that was for me. I wasn't really sure about that. I believe it is just that over time, that's through certain concrete circumstances, I ended up here.